This video is on cell communication. Cell communication is when cells in multicellular organisms send signals between cells . For example, a neuron can send a message to another neuron, or a neuron can send a message to a muscle. Immune cells can communicate with each other. All the cells in an organism communicate to help that multicellular organism function. Cells in unicellular organisms can communicate as well. So unicellular organisms can signal each other to produce a group response. For example, quorum sensing in bacteria, which is such a cool thing. A cell signaling pathway has three primary pieces: reception, transduction, and response. Reception is when the signal molecule or ligand attaches to a receptor. This is the first step. So the signal molecule, which can also be known as a ligand, attaches to a receptor. This ligand can be a protein, which would use a cell surface receptor, because proteins tend to be large molecules that can't pass through the phospholipid bilayer, so they have to link up to a receptor on the cell surface. Or the ligand could be a lipid molecule. Lipids tend to be smaller, nonpolar hydrophobic molecules that can easily pass through the phospholipid bilayer. So they usually use intracellular, meaning inside the cell, receptors. Once the signal is received, we have transduction. Transduction is how the signal passes through the cell. Now, with a lipid, the lipid and its receptor usually just diffuse through the cell to the nucleus to provoke a response, or maybe a cytoplasmic response, but usually a nuclear response for lipids. But with proteins, a lot of times it's a little bit more complicated. You have something called a phosphorylation cascade that can occur. You can use relay molecules. And these often are used when we're talking about protein signaling and transduction. The signal can be amplified. So these all really have to do with protein ligands, or you can just have diffusion of the lipid ligand and its receptor. So we'll talk about these in more detail later, but these are just some vocab words that kind of go through this process of transduction. How the signal passes through the cell, passes through the cytoplasm of the cell. The last part of a cell communication pathway, a cell signaling pathway, remember we have reception, transduction, and response, is the cellular response. A cellular response can be cytoplasmic, for example, you can have an increase or decrease in enzyme activity in the cytoplasm. Or a response can be nuclear. With a nuclear response, we're talking about changing what's happening to the DNA and maybe ultimately affecting what's happening with protein synthesis. So an example for a nuclear response is transcription factors, and which are usually proteins, or they could be the lipid ligand with its receptor. And these transcription factors can alter the rate of protein synthesis. So they can increase or decrease the production of a specific protein. So this is the general process of cell signaling. Now we're going to get into how a protein and lipid signal actually go through this entire process of reception and transduction and response. So let's start off with our lipid. As I said earlier, lipids are small, nonpolar, hydrophobic molecules, so they can travel easily through the phospholipid bilayer. So remember, this cell membrane is primarily made up of phospholipids. And yes, phospholipids are amphipathic, meaning they have polar heads and nonpolar tails, but primarily they are lipid molecules and they're primarily hydrophobic. So if we think about this lipid signal right here, it's small, nonpolar, and hydrophobic, so it can easily pass through the phospholipid bilayer. And then it can bind with this specific cytoplasmic receptor here. And we have a lot of specificity that occurs between the signal, and remember that we're calling this a lipid signal, but we can also call it a lipid ligand here, or ligand, okay? The signal and this receptor are very specifically matched to each other. So remember, this lipid signal can easily pass through the phospholipid bilayer. And so with lipid signaling, you often see the response as kind of slow and long-term, okay? So these are considered like slow, long-term messengers. A good example of this would be like estrogen or testosterone. And these are lipid signals that can be used for puberty, producing secondary sexual characteristics and things like that. Okay, so let's talk about reception, transduction, and response. So reception I have in blue, transduction I have in pink, and response I have in green. So with reception, this is occurring inside the cell for the lipid signal. There's an intracellular receptor. That's binding with the signal. So the ligand and the receptor bind inside the cell. That's reception for a lipid signal. For transduction here, okay, this lipid signal slowly diffuses towards its final destination. And a lot of times with lipids, that's the nucleus. Okay, so you see this lipid signal is diffusing towards the nucleus. And it's a signal now because here's the lipid ligand, and here is the intracellular receptor. So this is called a complex because the two of these are together. So now we're talking about transduction right here. In this transduction process, okay, this complex, the lipid ligand cytoplasmic receptor complex, diffuse towards the nucleus. That's all that's happening here. And this is why this is a slower process here. So once this complex has diffused through the cytoplasm, okay, we're heading towards the nucleus where we're going to get a nuclear response here. And what's actually going to happen is this lipid ligand and receptor complex are going to act as a transcription factor. So they're going to bind to the DNA, and they're going to either increase or decrease the rate of transcription here. So here's the DNA. They're going to either increase or decrease the rate of transcription, the rate of mRNA production of a certain gene, and that's going to lead to more or less of a protein being made. So the response in this case is a nuclear response. The complex acts as a transcription factor. Which will increase or decrease transcription of a gene. And that means this will modify gene expression, which means it will modify the amount and type of protein made. And there's a response right there. Now, in the second video, we're going to talk about how proteins can have this reception transduction response. This one was focused on the overall signaling pathway, what reception is, what transduction is, and what response is, as well as how a lipid ligand can act as a signal causing reception, transduction, and response. And in this case, we're talking about a nuclear response.